Hey, what's up? My name is PJ, and in this video, I'm going to be answering a viewer question. Hope you enjoy. So before I start, I just want to say to you guys, if anyone has a question, because I do get a couple in my email or in the comments of the videos from time to time, if you have a serious question that you would like to answer, you would like me to answer on video, please send me an email at pj@bigpantsphoto.com and maybe just put in the title, in the subject, viewer question. If I get a couple at a time or if I get a good one, I'm happy to answer them on video. And if it helps you, I can only hope that it will help other people as well. So if you have any, please feel free to submit. The other thing that I want to say is I'm going to be starting up the music photography podcast again. I did an episode last week and I'm going to do more in future. If you have any suggestions, please also send them to me in a comment or an email or whatever. Anyway, this question comes from my friend, viewer, subscriber, and this is my big chance to pronounce your name correctly. Rui Marques. That's my best Portuguese. Thank you so much, Rui. Oh my goodness, that's so hard. I'm sorry. Please forgive my clumsy Australian tongue. Rui Marques. Rui, thank you so much for the email. This kind gentleman also made me a video with a short Portuguese lesson and teaching me how to pronounce his name as well. So, Rui, here we go. Basically, the gist of the email is Rui is going to be taking on some jobs as a concert photographer. He's never really done it before. He's applied for a pass to shoot a heavy metal festival to start to build his portfolio. And basically from using this job, he wants to use that portfolio to get more paid jobs, which will be available in the next couple of months. So my main concern is the light level and high ISO required. I have a Sony A7 II crop sensor and it's not a high ISO god by any means. So he's got all the lenses, 35, 50mm, 16-50, 70-200. Glass is not a problem. And the festival that's coming up is going to have videos recorded. So I'm assuming the point of that is there's going to be light, there's going to be available light to shoot with. What kind of settings do you use for these photos? I'm expecting to shoot the lens wide open. The shutter will probably be around 1/60th to 1/250th. I'm not sure if the shutter 1/250th is fast enough to freeze the stage action. The ISO is where I may fail, or the camera. Any chance to keep things at a maximum of 3200? Rui, the thing about ISO that I find is even on an older camera, if you get a good exposure, you don't have to worry about noise at all. Not at all, but you don't have to worry about noise. It's there, it's grain, it is what it is. It's so much better to have a grainy, noisy photo than to have motion blur or to miss a photo because you didn't have the right settings. So I've never used this camera myself, but I used to shoot on a Nikon D7000. That was probably, I think 6 or 7 years ago, maybe a bit less, maybe 5 or 6 years ago. I can't remember exactly. But that thing wasn't that great in low light either. I would pretty much never push it past 1600 or 2000. And that's because exactly what you describe. I was just afraid of pushing it too high in case my photos weren't usable. But the truth is, if you have a good exposure, like the more light you have, the more not noticeable the noise is going to be. So you could easily get away with 3200. Will 1/250th be fast enough to freeze the action? It's a good question. It depends what the bands are doing. If they're jumping off things and running around really fast, probably not. I think for most bands, 1/250th is a good starting point. You can judge it by what the person on stage is doing. If there's a singer behind a microphone, you can stop down to 1/100th, because the chances are if they're in front of a microphone, they're not moving that fast. You can easily freeze them, get them nice and sharp, even if everything is moving around them. Similarly, if you've got a guitarist or a bass guitarist, they're probably going to be swapping sides depending on how big the stage is. They're going to be moving around, I would hope. If they don't, it's a pretty boring show. But those sort of guys, you would have to shoot at a bit of a faster aperture. So 1/250th is a good starting point. What I like to do usually is I'll set my ISO. If you want it to be 3200 maximum, start there, wide open on your lens. I think most of your lenses are around 2.8. Between 2 and 2.8 is probably your best bet, I would think. 1.8, you'll probably miss focus a little bit, particularly on a crop sensor body. But f2 on your primes or 2.8 on the rest of your lenses. So set your ISO to 3200, and then you adjust your, they call it riding your shutter, depending on the situation. So if you know the brightest part of the stage, you can expose at f2.8, 3200 at 400th of a second, then you follow your subject in and out of that bright point. If they move out into a darker spot, then you ride the shutter speed down. You click it down 2 or 3 notches to account for the fact that they're not in the brightest light in the center of the stage, let's say. Similarly, if they're going from a dark part of the stage, moving to a lighter part, you ride it up back to 400 because you know your exposure at that center point of the stage, at that bright spotlight or wherever the brightest part of the stage is, you know that that's going to be 400th of a second. That's probably the biggest advice I could give. And going back to the ISO for a second, I would say if you're not getting paid for this, if you're doing it to experiment, shoot the first 2 songs or the first 1.5 songs, depending on how many songs they give you. Shoot them safely, get the photos you need, get some safe ones in the bank so you can deliver a product. And then for the last song or song and a half, when you're just going to upgrade your photos, I want you to take a risk and really test the limits of your camera. I want you to try shooting up to 4,000, 5,000, 6,400. Like I said, if you've got a good exposure, I promise you it's not as bad as you think it would be. Maybe 6,400 is pushing it a bit too far for crop sensor, but just try it. Just try going a little bit higher, see how it is. Worst case scenario, you can do a little bit of noise reduction in Lightroom. If you're shooting on RAW, you've got some control, you can add the color in, you can fix it up a little bit. I think you'll be surprised. Like I said, if you get a good exposure, the grain doesn't matter too much because your photo is sharp and the brighter parts of the image, you can't see the grain anyway. It's only when it's a really dark situation that is where the grain really comes through, particularly the color noise, because the texture of the grain is not always the issue. Yes, you lose a bit of detail, but the color noise is where it really tends to fall apart. So give it a try. Rui, my clumsy Australian tongue strikes again, has also included a photo gallery on Flickr to some of his pictures, which I'm going to check out here. So this is high ISO on the camera. Honestly, it looks fine. I know what you mean, you lose a bit of detail, but this is, let's have a look at the settings, 3200, 1/60th, 2.8. Remember as well, this is not stage lighting. Stage lighting is meant to be bright, even if it's the wrong color, hopefully it's meant to be, it's a production, right? It's supposed to be consumed first by the punter, by the people at the show, but it is a production, so like you said, it's going to be videoed. People, there are going to be photographers shooting it, and I think you can really do a good job. Having a look at these photos, they're completely fine. Like I said, you can clean it up a little bit in post. If you've got your composition right, if you can freeze the motion, if your focus is good, the ISO doesn't matter as much. Thank you guys so much for watching. Like I mentioned at the start, if you have any questions that you would like me to answer on video, you can either drop them in a comment or you can DM them to me or send me an email, pj@bigpantsphoto.com. I would be very happy to answer them on the channel, and it helps me with content because I'm always looking for stuff for more content. Otherwise, hope you enjoyed it. Give me a big fat thumbs up if you did, and I will see you in the next video.